excess of 12 to 13 billion US dollars. And any reduction, any saving on that would be a saving for the Indian steel industry, as well as, you know, reduction or saving in the foreign exchange, you know, that goes out, you know, in those transactions. So we have, you know, we are committed to that, and we are also build up this platform for sourcing of metallurgical coal, and several steel producers such as Tata Steel and Steel Authority have already done, you know, pilot cases through that platform. A million tons of, as my colleague mentioned to me, a million tons of metallurgical coal has, you know, already been sourced by, you know, the steel company, the steel company through that platform. So we will continue to invest in this particular platform and to make this platform, you know, as the one-stop shop for all the Indian steel manufacturers to source metallurgical coal through this, which would lead to discovery of prices, okay, transparent discovery of prices, and which would lead into the price index. And once you have the price index, then that would be the basis for long-term contracts and many other financial, you know, instruments. So that is one. The second is that, you know, you would have heard the importance of using scrap in steel making to reduce the, you know, emission of greenhouse gases. There's a very, very stiff market. And while it is now important to use scrap in steel making, availability of scrap is a concern. I think many speakers pointed out that since India is a young economy, the availability of scrap is a concern. And whatever scrap which is available is not known to these steel manufacturers. There are not processes for that scrap to be, you know, made available to these steel manufacturers. Here, M Junction has taken some pioneering steps. We have created a platform that links all these scrap providers. This could be, you know, the people who deal with construction and dismantle scrap. So wherever you know, people who are engaged in dismantling structures, we are be able to reach out to them. They are on the platform, and they are able to offer this scrap to these steel buyers. We are also engaged with the RVSFs, you know, registered, you know, vehicle scrapping facility, which have gone live so far in terms of making scrap end of life vehicles also available to the steel, you know, producers. So our endeavor is that we are able to help in the cause of recycle, you know, reuse, by making all the scrap available. Because, you know, one of the issues is that many times the scrap gets just rusted and gets wasted. Is in terms of the scrap made available to the steel customer, steel producer, in the with great amount of reliability on supply. It's not only a question of sourcing, but what the steel companies need is that there should be reliability in terms of supply. So not only there's a platform which connects the steel buyer with the scrap supplier, but we are, the platform also provides continuous visibility to the steel buyers as the scrap is loaded, and as the scrap, you know, vehicles carrying scrap are, you know, on the way, that they are able to plan their steel production based in terms of what is the scrap which is in transit. So these are the two key initiatives on the platforms that, you know, we have built. As you are aware, we are in the business of building, maintaining digital platforms that help you know, the businesses which transact on our platform get exceptional results. I think yesterday some of the speakers made mention that it is not just about e-commerce. What we are interested in is in terms of results. Results that deliver, which are in line with what their requirements are. So we have today more than 3 lakh businesses transacting on our platform. The value of transaction that happens on our platform is in excess of $30 billion. We have taken a target to help more than 1 million businesses on our platform. So from 300,000 we are targeting to help more than 1 million businesses across the world in terms of transacting goods and services in excess of $100 billion in the next 5 years. With these, I'll take a pause and wait for any questions that you may have.
So how you are going to recycle so that the carbon footprint will be reduced?
Okay. So